Breaking news just moments ago. Pfizer now says that two vaccine doses may not be enough to protect against this infection from the new Omicron variant that we're seeing. That protection gets better, though, with a booster dose. With us now is Mikael Dolsten. He is the chief scientific officer. He's the president of worldwide research, development, and medical of Pfizer. And we also have our own CNN chief medical correspondent, Dr. Sanjay Gupta. And Sanjay, you're the expert here. We're going to let you take it away with questions.
Okay. Well, thank you. Good morning, Dr. Dolsten. Thanks for joining us. The news that a lot of people heard over the past couple days is that there was a 40-fold drop of neutralizing antibodies against Omicron as compared to the original strain. You have said in the past that a 10-fold reduction would be of concern to you. So please help us put this together. What is the level of concern right now?
Good morning, and thank you for having me here. We believe that with the two doses, you still have relevant protection for severe disease. But clearly, the drop in antibodies is substantial. However, the good news this morning is that our data show convincingly when you get your boost, the third boost, the antibody level rise 25-fold and are now similar to originally two-dose boost that protected well against ancestral strains as well as Delta. So all in, go and get your third boost and you have a robust, quite impressive antibody response as well as a strengthening of the other arm of the immune system, the T cells. So that's really the takeaway. You're right, two doses is on the weekend against this new variant. T cells may help you to be protected against severe disease, hospitalization, but it's really time to get the third boost, and you should be very encouraged by this morning's news.
Okay, so I just want to make sure I got that straight. So what you're basically saying is that three doses against Omicron is similar to what we saw with two doses against the original strain, and that a third shot here really does increase your level of protection. Is it your position now that to be fully vaccinated, that would mean you'd have three shots as opposed to two?
I think that's a good way to look at this. As we got the Omicron strain, the breadth of the immune response, the repertoire, as we call it, to cover Omicron as a new, more distant relative to the ancestral strain, it really do recover three doses. So,
okay, so you'd recommend, and I just want to be clear, when you talk about the effectiveness of the vaccine, I think we often commingle breakthrough infections with illness. When you have a drop in the effectiveness of the vaccine that you're talking about here, do you mean that people are more likely to develop these infections? They may just test positive without having much in the way of symptoms? Or are we talking about protection against severe illness that drops off as well?
I think with the two doses, you are expected to still have some protection against severe disease.
But what does that mean, some protection?
Well, you know, what we really need is data coming from observational studies on large number of patients that are vaccinated, two doses, and are exposed. And such data is gathering. What we can only say is that the T cell response is still active, as 80% of the vaccine sequence seems to still cover the relevant responses for Omicron. But for your antibody response, which plays a critical role to prevent infection and symptomatic disease, it's down with two doses quite a lot. If you get your third boost, it rises 25-fold, very dramatic. So yes, in a way you could say to be protected of Omicron, you really need a three-dose series of vaccination. And that's how we should look at it right now. The three-dose series is what you need.
To be fully vaccinated, you're saying. I know that there has been some development work on a Omicron-specific booster. Would you advise, based on the data that you're seeing, that people potentially wait for that booster, or they go ahead and get a boost of the existing vaccine now?
I advise, and Pfizer BioNTech advise, given on this new data that we are presenting, that everyone should get vaccinated, and those that have given the two doses should, as soon as possible, get the third dose. The supply of the third dose is available in US and many, many other countries. And there is really no time to wait until March next year, when we will have, as per our plans, a variant vaccine available just to cover all opportunities of what we may learn meanwhile. Whether we need a variant vaccine or there may be need for additional boosts as we get into spring 22, that needs to be evaluated. We do believe that the third boost will carry you well protected for Omicron through the winter and into the March season, when we have announced we have ability to produce 4 billion regimens of vaccinations, 4 billion doses that can be either continued of the current or start of a supply of an Omicron variant vaccine. We do see experiments performed by us testing various variants that there is some plausibility to consider a variant vaccine. We just want to be certain about the durability and the strength of the current vaccination before recommending a step. But you can feel well comforted by us having those two options in hand, that large capacity to produce vaccines, and working with many agencies in the US and elsewhere to monitor the threat of Omicron or any possible other variant that may emerge from now to then. We really don't know how strong Omicron will be circulating in the spring. So that's why it is work in preparation. But I think we have all the tools available. And just to end my optimistic message today with a third boost data that we believe will cover everyone through the winter season, we're also in the very final days and weeks of seeking regulatory approval for an oral treatment for COVID that with a 5-day tablet treatment seems to predict to be highly active against Omicron. All our modeling data shows it should be active against Omicron, and you will hear soon about this from us. So I think there is encouragement of ample opportunity to keep us going through the winter season, as we come to spring, we'll understand which is the coronavirus mutation most available and which of the vaccine opportunities should we deploy.
Okay. Well, Dr. Dolsten, thank you for leaving us on that optimistic note. Appreciate your time. We'll come back to you as well, talking more about those oral pills in the future. Thank you. The headline, Brianna John, as you heard, a 25-fold increase in neutralizing antibodies with that third shot. This can be a big topic of discussion. Is it three shots that are required to be considered fully vaccinated or not? You heard, obviously, from Dr. Dolsten what he thinks on that.
Sanjay, just to be clear so people know, the big takeaway here this morning, if you're going to take the optimistic view from Pfizer, which is the company producing this vaccine, so they have an interest here. But the bottom line here is they seem to be saying if you get a booster, you are protected against Omicron. That sentence, as we head into the winter, with whatever uncertainty exists about Omicron, that's a big deal.
That is. I mean, because I think for the last few days, obviously, there's been a lot of uncertainty. And then I think what everyone heard over, you know, just a day ago was there was a 40-fold drop in neutralizing antibodies. Now, that doesn't mean that there's a 40-fold drop in vaccine effectiveness. Those two things don't translate directly. But obviously, it's concerning when you have that sort of drop. What Dr. Dolsten is saying, what the Pfizer data is showing, is that that third shot does significantly increase, 25-fold at least, your overall neutralizing antibodies. And keep in mind, there's a big cushion that we talk about here. So if you have a 25-fold increase in neutralizing antibodies, you know, he says that that'll provide you the protection you need through the winter.
Well, the markets are reacting positively to this news. Not that they all have medical degrees, but they like this in terms of what it might mean for the winter. Sanjay, thank you so much for helping us out with this and helping us understand the significance of it. And of course, everyone should catch the new episode of Sanjay's Chasing Life podcast. The episode is titled In the Blink of an Eye, about a woman's accident that Sanjay chronicles.